The Empire's on the run. Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
Using unparalleled research in the development of a synergistic formulation based around the key concepts of superoxygenation, the next level in cleansing is here. With key ingredients backed by real clinical studies, the new Oxy Powder, available through InfoWars Life, was invented during Dr. Group's research on the toxification of our bodies. Many herbal colon cleansers are harsh on the body and contain cheap and potentially dangerous ingredients, oftentimes full of synthetic fillers, GMOs, additives, or worse. Gently start cleaning your body with easy capsules that start working while you sleep. Oxy Powder does not require time off work, and there's no need for bad-tasting concoctions. Instead, Oxy Powder slowly releases monoatomic oxygen into the intestinal tract and body. Experience the astonishing cleansing power of superoxide and ozonide technology. Go to InfoWarsLife.com or InfoWarsStore.com to get started with Oxy Powder, or call 1-888-253-3139.
The government's Department of Homeland Security is buying up loads of ammo. At the same time, they're restricting civilians' rights to own and purchase firearms. Can you put two and two together? Infidel Body Armor can stop every round, including hollow points and 308 sniper rounds, is reasonably priced and fully legal. But for how long? Go to InfidelBodyArmor.com, spelled I-N-F-I-D-E-L, BodyArmor.com. Infidel Body Armor. Just won't quit.
When cells become toxic, they die early and aging sets in. No one has put together a formula that focuses directly on brain health, nerve growth factors, and optimizing your cellular energy at the same time. Just one of the key compounds, BioPQQ, is backed by major clinical studies. You want the best that's out there at the lowest price anywhere? We now have the synergistic solution. Secure your DNA force today at InfoWarsLife.com or call toll-free 888-253-3139.
The experts are clear. Sunlight, purified water, healthy non-GMO food, and having a good attitude is essential to a healthy immune system. But I go further with Super Nascent Iodine X2 from InfoWarsLife.com. 50% stronger than our original and revolutionary Nascent Iodine formula, coming from a deep earth crystal source that no other supplier has. Most other forms of iodine come from seaweed in areas plagued by Fukushima and other contaminants. Not our iodine. It comes from over 200 million year old crystal salt deposits and is tested and proven to be completely pure. Visit InfoWarsLife.com today. See the informational videos, read the information there compiled, and for a limited time, when you use promo code NOW at checkout, you get an additional 5% off the entire family of InfoWarsLife.com products. Secure your Survival Shield X2 today at InfoWarsLife.com or call toll free 888-253-3139.
Waging war on corruption.
Resistance to tyrants is obedience to God. It's Alex Jones.
I want to play this clip of Obama defending his stance on not instituting a travel ban. Yeah, they keep saying it lets medical workers go and help. They're on military, CDC, and UN flights. That's just not true. They're issuing visas to people. Folks are coming in. The main hub is Nigeria. They come in out of other Ebola-affected countries. They get on and start projectile vomiting everywhere. They clearly want it to spread, folks. If they didn't engineer it and soup it up as it appears to be, last longer in the body, can spread further, has a higher kill rate, then they bare minimum let it come in. Look, you didn't think the socialists and the globalists were going to just get control of the country and not fully wreck it. Do you just think Obama's going to leave office without totally wrecking the country first? And they think the controlled media will protect them to the point. You've heard the big White House reporters when the mics they think are off going, man, we're screwed. This is really bad. It's spreading. But when they ask the questions, oh, gracious leader, thank you for saving us. You're so perfect. Because if you don't ask questions like that, you don't get let in. Do we all have a suicide pact with these crazy people running the government? And I'm going to explain something. It's a bunch of corporate special interest that will make trillions off a full-bore worldwide Ebola pandemic, that they will medicalize, that they'll create the vaccines for, that they'll get the countries into debt. They create wars. They fund Al-Qaeda. They promote diseases because they get power out of the global crisis management system they've built. That's why they don't want locals to ever be prepared to do anything. That's why they block locals in Katrina and block local police and others, because they want to come in, screw everything up, and then get even more funding so they can, quote, do a better job next time. Problem, reaction, solution. Here is Obama defending his stance on not instituting a travel ban. Here it is.
I don't have a philosophical objection necessarily to a travel ban if that is the thing that is going to keep the American people safe. The problem is that in all the discussions I've had thus far with experts in the field, experts in infectious disease.
Oh, really?
Is that a travel ban is less effective than the measures that we are currently instituting. If we institute a travel ban instead of the protocols that we put in place now, history shows that there is a likelihood of increased avoidance. People do not readily disclose their information. They may engage in something called broken travel, essentially breaking up their trip so that they can hide the fact that they have been to one of these.
They're already doing that.
There is a disease in place. And as a result, we may end up getting less information about who has the disease. They're less likely to get treated properly, screened properly, quarantined properly. And as a consequence, we could end up having more cases rather than less.
Okay, that's from NBC News. How did we get the current Ebola outbreak? Let me think back. Because liar-in-chief, you know, he just told me that he's trying to keep me safe and trying to keep you safe. They told us that there wasn't any threat of it coming here. And then a man from Liberia who knew he had it flew here and ran around for weeks vomiting on everyone. But that's okay because Jesse Jackson said it, we were racist. Why not? We're bad. We deserve it. And then they didn't quarantine his family and let his kid go to school. And then two nurses got it, which they said were impossible. You had to be vomited on into an open wound. And now the nurses were flying around everywhere. And now you've got people flying in out of Africa, vomiting and dying on the plane. And dead people being found in Houston that just came in from West Africa. Everything's fine, though. I think they're trying to get Ebola. I think it's really clear now. It really just clicked. They don't want it to just get started spreading. They want it to spread real bad before we know, so folks don't start self-quarantining and making the right procedures, because they know the states will take matters in their own hands and stop it. They want it to get so bad, it's unstoppable. That's it. Total commitment to spread Ebola as bad as possible and to just be handing out the visas like hotcakes to anybody that wants to come here. You know, oh, you're bleeding and vomiting? Get on the plane. You want to vomit on everybody on the plane? Vomiting so bad the person died flying into New York. Oh, my gosh. This is I've flown a JFK so many times. They rob your bags there. I've had the airport screening people rob me twice. Very nice people. In a troubling report that has surfaced amidst growing fears of an Ebola outbreak in the U.S., a man has died following a vomiting fit, because you die usually. I never heard of that before. En route to New York City on a commercial flight originating from Nigeria. The CDC is yet to go on record confirming or denying whether or not the man may have been infected with Ebola. The New York Post reports a plane from Nigeria landed at JFK Airport last night with a male passenger aboard who died during the flight after a vomit fit. Oh. Well, whatever he's got, we've sure need to spread it, or you're racist. And CDC officials conducted a cursory exam before announcing there was no Ebola. A cursory, it's an exam. And turning the corpse over to the Port Authority cops to remove. Yeah, how'd you like that job? Of course, that's the same airport where for 2 weeks they're refusing to clean the planes because they say there's so much vomit and blood on them. Oh, it's here. They're bringing all of them in. But they always said it would be the Muslim extremists would go get infected and come in. They don't need to. Our government will take someone with Ebola and bring them in to treat them, or they'll take somebody who has it and take them and put them in a regular hospital.
And all the major independent experts are saying send them to special government facilities that are already there, quarantine them. That was default. Look, it's a default, folks. So I want to hurry through your calls now. I've talked enough, and I've gone too long. I want to take a bunch of them now. Austin, Aaron, Ray, racist. That means they didn't want Ebola. Shane, just have your question, your comment ready right now. Austin in Michigan, you're on the air. Go ahead, sir.
Hey, how's it going, Alex?
Well, I mean, I'm kind of ashamed of myself. I don't want Ebola to kill me and my family, so I'm racist. And I'm kind of upset that Rachel Maddow and CBS News and the White House and all these other organizations, Media Matters, that they control, that's when I say the White House, have said that I and others are bad. That really shakes me up to be, that they are my authority. They are my God because they're known liars. And I'm really shook up right now that socially they've said this about me. I'm gonna run out right now and bring an Ebola patient back to my house just to prove to Geraldo Rivera that I'm not racist. Go ahead.
I was called to talk about, I don't know if you've ever heard of, you ever read the book, The Cure for All Diseases?
No, I haven't read that.
It's a book by an independent research scientist. Her name is, it's Helda Regeer Clark.
Okay, well, tell me what they're claiming, because I don't think there's a, quote, cure 100% of the time for anything.
Well, it has to do with, you ever hear of bioradiation?
Oh, they're claiming they have like a Raymond Rife machine or something?
No, everything you see emits a frequency, you know, a life frequency.
And that's Rife machines. There is some real evidence that there are different frequency treatments, and we know bad frequencies out of cell phones are giving us cancer. But then there's so many quacks. I don't know the book you're talking about, so I'm not saying they're a quack. There are so many quacks out there selling BS machines. I mean, I've been offered, let's not exaggerate, machines that are like $10,000. They cost about $1,000 to make. I've been offered $5,000 per machine to sell them, and I won't because I've gone and looked into what they are, and it's not real. I think the claim that, you know, frequencies can heal everything isn't true. I appreciate your call. But if you know, you can fire radiation through a tumor and kill it, it just might kill everything else around it. So the answer is, are there other good forms of frequencies that can resonate at a certain level to kill viruses and things? Well, yes. Sunlight kills viruses. But how do you get sunlight into every area of the body? So, of course, frequencies can do things. But it should be studied mainline and deployed. The Queen of England, it comes out, gets frequency treatments. But she goes to real government facilities, very secretive stuff. Queen Mother lived to 100 and something. She would get it. They'd take her blood out and put it through ozone machines and stuff. Prince Philip gets it. So, yes, I'm saying, it's like alternative energy. There's a lot of real alternative energy, but most of the stuff out there is a scam. So I don't promote it because it's such a minefield. So that's Royal Raymond Rife stuff you're talking about, sir. Let's talk to Aaron. And his research was real overall. It got a little bit far out there towards the end. Aaron in Ohio, you're on the air.
Hey, Alex. Thanks for taking my call.
Thank you, brother.
I think I know what's going on with this, and I think it's a false flag. We know that. However, I think what they're trying to do is the linchpin of this whole New World Order takeover is they have to have us convinced to take these vaccines. So I think...
Oh, yeah, that's it. That's it. Bring in medical tyranny, forced inoculations, grandstanding, and they've got to get it going enough to scare the daylights out of people. And they're saying, take your flu shot and we won't quarantine you. What does that mean? Well, if you're sick, we'll quarantine you. See the threat? We'll lock you up with Ebola patients if you don't do this. It's pure terrorism. We're being terrorized. Go ahead.
Well, see, they have to. They have to, though, because we're getting to the point now where 40% of the populace now is around roughly that number is not vaccinating their children anymore. The walls of that tyranny is starting to fall down. We have whistleblowers. We have lawsuits against Bill Gates in India. And things like that.
Over his polio stuff, giving people polio by the hundreds of thousands.
Yeah.
You're right. And so what's happening is, just like Red Adair would blow up an oil well fire with a bigger explosion, they need a big, giant explosion. I mean, the globalists would launch a nuclear war before they were ever removed from power. That's why you've got to culturally identify them and reject them and just literally shun them. That's the way to defeat them, not militarily, not in some coup or something or counter-coup. We've got to overthrow their system intellectually by recognizing it. That's why they want to dumb us down. And you're absolutely correct that it's all about